Hey, what's up guys? Today your boy Jet and I is here with my first tutorial. So basically today I'm going to show you how to activate your Windows permanently and unlock all personalization and any customization without any error. So everyone in the comment section of my previous video just asked me about how to do it. So in this tutorial, we don't need any software or third party plugins. We don't want those such things to be downloaded. So basically we can download it with this text document actually. So before jumping into the video, I have a little reminder to you. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please hit that red subscribe button right away in the bottom. It means a lot to me. Thank you for that. So with that being said, let's jump right away to the video. Lift off. So guys, before going to the tutorial, let's get straight with the facts that why you need to activate your Windows. So basically, in Windows, sometimes the package may expire to some conditions. It means the purchase you done and the conditions may occur the Windows to be deactivated. So we do not need to be deactivated all the time, because when the system gets deactivated, the system limits our usage. So in order to make that usage to the maximum level, we need the Windows to be activated always. So let's see how you can see whether your Windows is activated or not. First, in the PC, we can right click in a blank or a free space and get to the properties section. So here you have all your systems, all your processor, installed memory, system type, and all such things, and then your company name, blah blah blah, etc. And in the last, the bottom section, we have the Windows activation panel. It says Windows is activated. So my computer has an activated Windows. So actually, I just activated Windows recently. So now you have a problem how to activate Windows. So if your Windows is not activated, it will show like Windows is not activated here. So another thing you can see that your Windows is not activated is when you're in the desktop, in the right bottom corner, you will have a little white watermark saying that your Windows is not activated, and a link will be also there. So you cannot actually permanently activate Windows via settings. Let me go to settings and update and security. This here you can check for updates and recovery, activation, and in the activation panel you can change the product key, but sometimes it may not work to some users. So the best way here is to activate your Windows permanently with the directory of your system C files. So let's see how we can do that. We need to have a little text file. I have the link to the file in the description below, so you can download it or give to the link. So with the link clicked, you will be directed to the site here. So this is the text you need to be needed to go with the command prompt to your system to be activated. So what you need to do is just hit the download button and it will download here within a second. So it is downloaded. So let's get back to the downloaded area. In my downloads, I have the file here saying Windows 10 activated 2017_win0.3. So it's better if we cut that file. Yeah, cut it to the desktop. So now we have this file Windows 10 activated. This is a notepad file, which is a text document actually. So double click on it and it will open in the notepad. So basically this is the all text we needed to do that install activation. So you don't want to be worried about that text, even I don't know what is all about it. So now what you simply want to do is go to file, save as, and then hit the, and you will be hit with this dialog box right here. Now it says the file name Windows 10 Activator 2017B_V0.13. Of course you can change it, but I do not prefer to change it. We need to add a little extension to this file to be executed as a program to be run on your computer. So what we are going to do is, after this you will have been selected like this, highlighted like this, you just click on the cursor here and it will be editable. So full stop BAT, that is the extension we are giving, .bat.bat, which is the abbreviation for the batch file. So with that being typed away, the encoding must be ANSI, not Unicode, Unicode Big or anything like that. The encoding should be ANSI. So I'm going to save this file into my Windows Essential folder in desktop. I prefer if you save this file also to the desktop. It's easy for you to activate your Windows within few seconds. So let's get to the Windows Essential, open and save. So I have a file with that name, so I want to replace it. Yes. Let's close it. And let's go to the Windows Essential. Yes, here we have our Windows 10 activator. So it's basically now a batch file with the extension we just gave, and the size will be 2.21 KB. Don't get over with that little size, because this simply is the activator for your whole Windows package, and whether it is home, professional, enterprises, or even education. So let's right click this one and run as administrator. With this message you have to hit yes. It asks about to allow this upcoming changes to your PC. You want yes. Now it will be running on your computer. You don't need to worry about anything. It will run automatically, and sometimes it may say the connection has error connecting to another server. It means your internet connection is not responding well. Then what you have to do is, if it happens every time, you just close, and when you get a nice stable internet connection, you can redo it. So here I have the connection to the server failed, trying to connect to another, please wait. That means my internet connection is at the moment is very slow. So actually guys, sorry to say, at the moment my internet connection is not responding as I thought. So it's simple, I don't need to show you. So I will say how to do it simply. When this Windows 10 is activation shows you here, if you have a good internet connection, it will automatically activate your system. And at the end it will ask you to for a restart, or you can skip that too, but I recommend you to restart so it will give you that changes to your system. So that's what you need to do. It's very simple, it's very methodical, it will 100% work, I guarantee. No fails, no virus, no such things, don't worry at all. So this is the easiest way to activate your Windows. So thank you for watching guys, and as always, if you haven't yet subscribed to me, please go hit that red subscribe button in the bottom corner. It means a very very lot to me. So, and again, if you want my videos and the notification, just hit that bell and get notified when I upload a video. So thank you guys for joining me with my first tutorial. Let's try to get 100 likes for this video, and hoping to see you with the next video coming soon. For then, have a good day. Peace.